Well, this video nearly didn't happen because RF Solutions have trusted us with this brand new product that is launching tomorrow, and I thought it'd be a great idea to demonstrate its application in some garden lighting. However, when somebody ordered the kit, the wrong one turned up. I thought I was getting mains voltage lighting. Instead, I got this low voltage kit, and we've had to do some engineering work to get it to work with the solution, and we'll circle back to how we did that later on. But this RIOT solution, you might have been thinking riot. Well, there was nearly a riot when this turned up, but let's have a look at the great features first. This dual band receiver's got four independent channels that can switch up to 1 kilowatt from a volt-free contact, so making it great for garden lighting. So you think the problem's garden lighting, you want to switch it from inside the house, you want to switch it from outside the house, this is where this product comes in. Of course, there's lots of other things we may want to control in the garden, such as pond pumps, electric patio heaters, or even electric gates. And that's where the four independent channels are really useful, because they can be completely different electrical circuits that you're controlling. So something with a high inrush current, such as a pond pump or possibly an LED driver, isn't going to affect other channels because they can be completely different circuits in their own right. Let's look at the practical installation elements first. The unit is supplied in this robust IP68 enclosure. We've got five entry points along the bottom. Comes with the glands as well, M20, external mounting options there, and this external aerial here to get maximum range. Before we look at range, here's a top tip when it comes to IP ratings. This box is IP68, this fixture's IP65, and we've hacked it to bits by removing the manufacturer's components to get it to work, but we will come back to that. So we worried about mismatch. If this joint failed, water could track up inside the cable and get into that box. To prevent that, use a gel box like this Barney. The gel stops any water traveling up the cable. I've got this Fobber remote control here, which gives you up to 200 meters of reception range in an outdoor environment like this. However, if you're in an environment where there's trees, other buildings, that can be reduced, but how can you check? The great thing about the RIOT, it's got an inbuilt signal strength receiver. Looks like a 1980s graphic equalizer that you might have had on your hi-fi, but it's a great diagnostic tool when you're setting this up. The flexibility of RF Solutions systems means if 200 meters on that remote isn't enough, you can swap to some of the other ones in the system, and this trap remote here would get you up to 2 kilometers of range. And if 2 kilometers isn't enough, we can move from the FM transmitters to LORA based receivers that get you an incredible 16 kilometers of range. And if 16 kilometers isn't enough, that's where the RIOT element of this device really kicks in, because as long as we can get a Wi-Fi signal to our receiver, we can then switch it from anywhere in the world. In the interest of research, I thought I'd best explore that infrared patio heating a little bit further. However, I seem to have turned up a little bit too early. Great for applications like this, where we have a big seating area here. You could divide it into individual zones, but we'd be worried about the customers coming in, switching the heating on and leaving, wasting energy. The great thing about the RIOT is you can have the outputs configured as timed outputs, so that your customer could trigger the heating in their area, and then it times out after minutes or possibly even an hour, so we're not wasting energy. Of course, for larger loads, we'd probably be switching them via a contactor as well. A lot of installers get nervous as soon as they hear the word IoT, or Internet of Things, and closely associated with that, an app. But this system is really easy to set up. There's a dedicated app for the installer to get the product onto the Wi-Fi network. Simply push the button in the box to start the training process. Then you move on to the two options for actual controls. There's a simple version, or there's a pro version of the app, which allows you to tailor the outputs of each individual channel and even set some really clever timer functions. Being able to switch things on from across the other side of the world is fantastic, but what if you're worried? What if you think, I've left something on? Can you check the state of the relays remotely? That is the great thing about the app. You can remotely interrogate the RIOT device, and the status of the relays is reflected in front of you in the app. Inside the box, there's a generous amount of wiring room so you can configure the system to your needs. And there's also some other features we can set up in there. The outputs can be either latching or momentary, depending on how you set this jumper link. And you can have timed outputs, which is shown on the graphic at the bottom of the board, but also displayed on that signal strength indicator. There's also a mode button to switch between FM and LORA radio systems, and that learn button as well to pair our remotes and app channels. And you can pair up to 128 channels, so that's a lot of remotes or a lot of apps. And the keen eyed amongst you might have spotted how we managed to power this 12 volt lighting system from this box. The secret is it can work off either mains voltage or low voltage, which is what we've done here. If you'd like to see how Rick did that, check out the extended footage here. If you'd like to learn more about dry, that sounds like plumbers words, or volt-free contacts, watch this video here.